Most of Australia has extensive periods of extreme heat, and one-tenth of the continent also has significant periods of below-freezing weather. Exposure to heat or cold is not confined to the outback or snowfields. The casualty may be an elderly person sitting quietly in a cold room, a homeless person in winter, a casualty in a boating mishap, a lost bushwalker, or even a person exercising in the middle of a hot summer's day. Heat exhaustion is caused by exposure to a hot environment with inadequate intake of fluids, insufficient shade during physical activity, or failure of the body's cooling mechanisms. The casualty will develop severe cramps, headache, confusion, poor judgment or coordination, particularly as their body temperature rises to 39 degrees Celsius. Rest the casualty in a cool, shaded place, position wet towels over the body, give small amounts of water, and seek medical aid urgently. Heat stroke is a potentially lethal condition. Fluid levels in the body become so dangerously low that sweating stops. This causes the body temperature to rise as it can no longer cool itself. The brain and other vital organs such as the kidneys and heart begin to fail. The person will look hot and red, feel fatigued, complain of a headache, nausea and dizziness, and may sometimes vomit. If the body temperature is over 40 degrees, they may collapse.
You okay? You guys need some help?
He just looks a bit hot.
Oh, wow, he's really hot. Hot, but he's not sweating. How long have you been riding for?
Oh, a few hours.
But he's not sweating. Oh, God.
Those most at risk of heat stroke are infants, the elderly and the sick, or those who exercise or work in hot environments. In managing heat stroke, move the casualty to a cool place and remove excess clothing. If the casualty is over 5 years of age, immerse their body in cold water up to the neck for 15 minutes. If this is not possible, wet the person with cool or cold water under a shower or hose. Ice packs or cold packs can be applied to the neck, armpits and groin to cool blood in the large blood vessels. Give cold fluids if fully conscious. If the casualty is under 5 years of age, cool them in a tepid bath, sponging frequently. If this is not possible, repeatedly moisten the skin and fan continuously. Overexposure to cold is also a progressive condition. When the body temperature falls to 35 degrees Celsius or below, this state is called hypothermia. Remove the person from the cold environment. Remove sources of heat loss such as wet clothing. Ensure the casualty is dry and gradually rewarmed. Give warm oral fluids if fully conscious. Severe shivering will occur at a body temperature of 35 degrees. Severe hypothermia develops at 33 degrees. At 32 degrees, shivering stops, and at this point, active rewarming should occur. This rewarming is where application of external heat can be applied, such as a heat pack or body-to-body contact. Below 28 degrees, a casualty is severely hypothermic. The heart may beat irregularly. At 20 degrees Celsius, the heart will stop.